A mysterious group seems hell-bent on capturing Nels and Ninian. Having failed, this group, the Black Fang, flees. Rumor has them traveling southwest. Lynn and her colleagues follow in hopes of recovering a lost heirloom. The Black Fang have made a stronghold at an abandoned castle in Cathalette. Its dark halls are alive with shadowy figures. Chapter 7X, The Black Shadow. Hi everyone, I'm Cinderay9, welcome back to Let's Play Fire Emblem 7. So the brother escaped, and the sister was rescued by a band of strangers. Do I understand you? Yes, they ambushed us and... Hold your excuses. The end is all that matters. Yes, ma'am. And your plan for recovering the siblings is? We've word that the entire group is headed this way, with the brats in tow. They're coming here? Why would they do that? They may well be after this ring. It's a rare piece. We took it from the girl. It was a stroke of luck that we did, especially if it brings them to us now. I'll grab the whole lot of them with this to bait the trap. I see. Very well. I'll give you another chance. I've business elsewhere, but I shall return once it's finished. You have it till sunrise tomorrow. Do you understand?
Yes.
If you do not have the children when I return, my hand will deal you the Fang's punishment. Remember that. Bear it closely in your mind.
Bye! Lock.
I believe they went in here. M'lady, are you really going in there to get the ring back? Yes, we are. But this is their stronghold! They're bound to be well defended, not to mention well armed. Please, forget about the ring. It's okay. Sindril's agreed to attempt this recovery. I wouldn't be here if not for that. Sindril believes we can do this. I'm sure that decision was not made lightly. Sindril at my side, I'm confident we can win. Let's get your ring back, Ninian.
M'lady...
M'lady Lindis! There are more of the foe inside than what we thought.
This is their stronghold. It's imperative we move carefully.
Exactly, m'lady. This narrow corridor can be used to our advantage. If we draw the enemy through here, we can engage them in small numbers and remain relatively safe. If time is a concern, we can always rush. If we do that, we'd better be sure we can win.
So, Sindril, what do you think? How we move forward is completely up to you.
That it is. And again, I don't make any decision lightly as their strategist. Alright, let's prepare for Chapter 7X. There are quite a few enemies here. As you can see. Like they said, there are a couple of narrow corridors you can use to your advantage. By plugging these corridors up, you force the enemy to either A, go around to attack you, or what's more than likely going to happen is they're just going to attack whatever's in front of them, as long as nobody else is in range. By doing that, you can put heavily armored units in front, and weaker units with weaker defense, such as Will or Wraith, or Urk that have ranged weapons, can attack from a safe distance. This guy drops a Vulnerary, which we'll be taking. Iron Axe, Iron Lance,
This guy has a door key. Now, he doesn't drop it, as you see, this mage. He also has a Thunder Tome. The Thunder Tome is a strong tome. It's a D nature tome. It's the step up from the Fire Tome. More might, less hit, but it does have 5 criticals, so be wary. Make sure that the mage doesn't have a critical percentage against whoever you throw him up against. I think a bit heavier at 6. Yeah, the fire weighs 4. 10 less hit, but 3 additional might. The Thunder Tome is a really good tome, and I like it a lot because it does have that 5 crit. Just a slight chance to crit, but it's there. It's just a little heavier, a little less hit, but that extra 3 might in the crit really helped balance it out. Good tome. If you want this door key, you're going to have to steal it. That is, of course, what Matthew is for. He can steal it. This guy has a Volinary that, again, you can steal. This guy has an Iron Sword and a Volinary. You can steal the Volinary. I believe we've gone over that. I don't think you can steal weapons in this version, even if they're not equipped. But we can test it out with the Cavalier. Maybe you can steal the Iron Sword. What's your speed? Oh, 5. That's fine. Matthew's faster than that. Iron Sword. Iron Axe. This thief has a speed of 9. How fast are you, Matthew? 11. Excellent. Has a lockpick that I want because we can steal it. Yes, you can steal from other thieves as long as you have a higher speed. Also make note, though, that the thief can steal from you. So, if the unit has a lower speed, the thief can steal things from you. Be careful with that. There is a little trick to that, though, that I'll go over in a little bit. But there's the lockpick to steal if you want the you want an additional lockpick. And I suggest you try to get it. Having an additional lockpick is not a bad thing. Iron Legs and the boss, Bayard, one of the Black Fang, hunts for Ninian and Nils. He is a mercenary. First time we've seen a mercenary. Professional soldiers with a balanced set of skills. I like mercenaries. I like mercenaries a lot. Like they said, they have a pretty balanced set of skills. He also has a steel sword, so he has an attack of 14. Not bad. He also has a B rank in swords. When they say a balanced set of skills, they're not kidding. Mercenaries are all around soldiers that use swords. They have typically good strength, good skill, some decent defense. Typically resistance is on the low side, and some okay luck. They are very well balanced and a very good unit. So that's our boss. And I think I've gone over everybody else's. They have stuff. You have a Volinary to steal as well. Matthew can steal a lot of stuff this episode if you give him the chance. To get into this room with the treasure chest, one of two things. You can either A, break down this wall, or B, you can come over here and open the door. Either way, there's an archer here that's just gonna love to shoot you. To get inside this area where the mage is with the door key, which you could also use if you steal the door key, again, you have to break down the wall. And the mage is going to love to hit you while you're breaking down the wall. Okay, before we can take 10 units. Same would really come in handy here. I don't think I showed this off last time. I apologize. If you press select, it says unit list. With this, you can see everybody's level, the EXP they need to level up. Scenario just needs one more heal. HP, their max HP. You can also see their strength magic, all their stats, and what they currently have equipped, their movement, their con. You can get all the information here. This is a very, very handy screen. And one that I should have showed off last time. I apologize. What's your defense? Director's 3. Sorry. I'm gonna take those. Okay, let's trade a few things. Oh, also, if you go to a list, you see a list of everything, and you can sort it by a type of item it is. This is really handy. That way you could, like, give Matthew a sword. It also says in the upper right corner, as you see, Owner Lin. It tells you who has said weapon. That way you know who you're taking it from. Take these for now. I need Matthew to have room. Take an iron lance. Good. Hold on to that. Who has... You have a Volinary. Give that to Matthew. And give this one to... Okay. Javelin, you now have a lance, correct? You don't have a Volinary though. Take this. Angelic robe. Hold on to this. Again. Everybody's good to go, I think. Pick units. My apologies. Let's set up the formation real quick. You're gonna go here. You're gonna go here. As long as we keep Florina away from the archer, she'll be fine. Okay. That should work. Let's save. And get this started. Alright. First things first. Lance, yeah, good. Dodge. And hit. Done. And get an extra Volinary. And the objective for this is to defeat all enemies. So you have to wipe them all out. We're going to break down this wall. That way we can get to the archer. Over here. Iron sword. Oh, you actually have some speed to you. Dodge. Okay. Good. Goodbye. Done. Of course, you'll be able to hit anybody within two spaces. So, move here. I don't want anybody else to be there, even though I'm gonna hit Kent anyway now that I think about it. Lynn. Lena. We're gonna need Matthew to steal from the chest anyway, so we'll send him over here. And Will this way. Have Will move again. And that gives Niles his first level up. HP, speed, luck. It's about what I expect. And of course, you can't get past Kim. You can sit here. And since he can move again, we'll now fire. Thank you, Will. Done. Alright. Now the enemy can go. The mage will more than likely shoot at... Yeah, expected that. And the mage is going to cast on Kent. See, there's that 4% chance to crit staring me right in the face. And 6 damage. And now the thief begins to move. Yeah. Okay. Attack. Yeah, you can't quite kill the archer. Movement 6, right. Attack the wall. How much do you do, Matthew? 6 times 2. That works for me. Play for Will. Now Will can fire. Good. And then, Matthew, you have something to steal? Oh, that's right, you can steal the Volinary. Attack 9. I want it, give it to me. He'll shoot Nulls, but he should survive. And as a just-in-case measure to give him one more HP. He should dodge, to be honest. He has so much speed and skill. But even if he doesn't dodge, he should live. He can't be doubled. Not by that guy. HP luck. Okay. Alright, now let's deal with this side over here. One more thing about the Manicotti. It is also effective against horsemen, as you can see. Not just armored units. These are the, I believe, the two units that the Manicotti is effective against. Effective against armored units, which technically I think that the Cavalier counts as, but it's also effective against horsemen. It's one of those. Regardless, it works on Cavaliers as well, as you can see. That's the gist of it. If you hit 9, huh? Geez, you have some might to you. That's for sure. Well, regardless, Kent is going to... Actually... no. Let's not do that. Well, actually, how much do you hit him for? Oh, you can flat out kill him. Thank you, Urk. I appreciate that. Please do so. Goodbye. Forget the door key. I really don't need it. I have Matthew. I'd rather him be dead. I'll steal the lockpick, is what I'll do. This is important. How much do you do? Oh, you can kill him. Nice. I would just like to give Lynn the kill, though, so... Oh, didn't crit. Ow! Goodbye! Thank you, Lynn! Now... How far do you move? To there, huh? Wait there. Not quite. If everybody wasn't in the way, I could just have Kent rescue Gnolls. But I just healed him instead. Oh well. Because I thought I was gonna break down the wall with Kent. It's fine. Let's pull you. And we'll equip the Iron Lance since you're using a sword. Just an iron sword, right? Always make sure. Go! You have a crit chance! Ow! And there's the crit! Yeah, 54% chance to hit, damage 4. You can get away with this now, but I warn you, you won't later. How? This can't be. They should be dead. Everyone, get in there and finish them. This is our final chance. Welcome to the reinforcement waves. This guy has an iron lance. He's gonna have to break out, though. Reinforcements will now begin appearing. I don't remember if this is the first map we've had reinforcements yet or not. We've had reinforcements before, right? If not, I guess I'll go over it now. In certain maps, reinforcements can show up. Like this guy just showed up out of nowhere. They usually come in indoor maps like this. They'll come from stairways more than likely. They'll show up on certain turns and will continue to show up for a number of turns. Again, it's hard to be specific because it's unique to each map. Always be wary of reinforcements showing up. I don't think you'll move. I really don't. Heal. As I was saying before the reinforcements, I can get away with Nals getting hit now. Do not expect that to last. I'm just doing it while I can. I could take the treasure, but I would honestly more like to have the lockpick. Thank you. I can get the treasure afterwards. Now the thief can't take the lockpick, so... far can you move? Goodbye! We're gonna play for Sarah! This is another thing you can do with your bard refreshing unit class. You can refresh the healer, that way they can go again and heal somebody up. Another thing you can do. These guys are also mercenaries. I didn't go over that. I just went over the boss. But yeah, there's the mercenary crit. They throw the weapon up in the air and then jump and spin down with it. An awesome looking critical animation. I just wish it didn't happen to Kent. Kill the reinforcement. Thank you, Urk. Now, Fulinary. You might come over here and hit Lin. Two 2% chance to credit that. If I remember right. What was your chance here? 2! So there you go! There it is! 2% chance to crit, and it happened! Keep that in mind! Use a Vulnerary. You're gonna stay there. I don't want to take Lucius too far out. You'll just wait there. You still have the Manicotti equipped, that's okay. Move Will up, and who hasn't gone? Florina. Who else had... You do. I took your lockpick. I'd love to steal these Vulnerys, so I'm gonna try to. Oh, you decided to come after Lin, huh? Alright! Bye! You're gonna go after Kent because of the Iron Lance. Clever game, clever. And the thief runs away because he no longer has a lockpick and he no longer has a reason to be here. However, more reinforcements have shown up. So we're gonna get Matthew out of here. A mage with the fire tomb and a shaman with the flux spell. Attack of 9, attack of 6. And there's still this soldier here. Movement of 5, right? Yes. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So as far as you can move. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. As far as you can move anyway. Good. Inside this treasure chest, we have a hammer. Hammer! Oh, he's full on stuff. Darn it. Should have traded that beforehand. Traded something beforehand. Oh, well. Hammer. Effective against knights. It is like the Armor Slayer, except as an axe. Very handy. The problem is, it has a very low hit percentage. when your inventory is full, you have to discard an item, which is a shame. Kinda wish I could take that turn back. Yeah, this is the problem with thieves. You have to keep an eye on their inventory. Oh well. Dropped a Vulnerary. I wish somebody could pick it up. I'd have had Sarah or Will or somebody just trade with him. That's a shame. Speaking of... Take the hammer. So he has a free space. Play? Thank you. Hail Will. Go. Resistance one. Ugh. They'll be able to hit anyway. All right. Shooting you. There we go. Sarah's over here, which is good. She'll be able to heal. She'll be able to heal them. Goodbye. Done. Oh, you can't quite make it. That's fine. How much do you do? 10? Again, that 2% chance to crit, but you only have one might. You're not gonna do enough. Ah, miss. Of course. Wait here, keep the Manicotti equipped. Wait here. Keep the Slim Lance equipped. Alright, Urk can move forward now. Yep, I figured. Oh, miss. Boy, this guy's really dodgy. He missed an 88. And I expected this. And I expect the shaman to attack Will. Like so. Good dodge, Will. Oh, that's a crit. You know, spins the arrow. Goodbye. Well done, Will. Good job. In that case, heal you. So that's stealing from a Volinary, and then I lose, the Volinary, of course. Oh well. Just shows I'm not flawless. Sure. Go. We're gonna move Matthew up to here. Play. No, I still haven't turned the animations off. HP do you have left? Yeah, that's right. You still haven't been hit. That gives 20 avoid. Okay, in turn. That's right, go swing at Matthew. Ugh. Regardless, he couldn't swing more than once. I want that Vulnerary back that I had to drop. Thank you. I can't quite reach. Well, let's see how this goes over here first. Oh, you're dead! That's the critical animation for the... not cleric, sorry, for the monk with the light magic. You see them put their hand in the air, and they get like a little bit of, you know, wind animation to their cloak and stuff. That's a critical. Good, Lucius. I really appreciate that. Thank you. Alright, all that leaves is the boss. With his attack power of 14. Healing you. Play for Sarah? I love that it says the hit percentage of 100. Heal Matthew. Why? Because it's EXP. There. Everybody move up. Okay, enemy's turn. Heal Lin. Move Lin forward. Lucius forward. I just want to see this, because I don't think it'll go well. Oh, one quit. Yeah. Oh, you have no chance to crit against Lin. Cool. One more thing about reinforcements. Wherever the reinforcements spawn, like, it's easy to tell in indoor maps. In outdoor maps... they can spawn from all kinds of places. They can just come in off the map. So it's harder to tell. Like I said, most of the time in indoor maps, they appear on stairs. That's where they like to show up. So, you can stop reinforcements by placing a unit on top of the stairs. A handy trick, if you really don't want to deal with reinforcements. Now, typically it's good to let them spawn, because that's another kill and that's more EXP. But if you really know your way through a Fire Emblem, or if you're just in bad shape, your units are just in a pickle, you could say, then use that technique. We're not going to attack, but we are going to wait. Now you get over here too. Intern.
I mustn't fail. I cannot fail. The consequences are too.
Ow. Goodbye! Thank you, Lin. Lin's just better than you. Please prove that in this level up. HP luck. And weapon level increased. What's with these level ups with the luck this episode? Whatever.
No. I cannot.
Give us the ring, and swear us this oath. You must promise to leave these two alone. If I have your vow, I'll spare your life.
Failure means death.
What? Poison? He took his own life.
These are no common brigands we're dealing with. This man was trained by a well-organized group.
What do they want with Niles and Ninian? Naus, Ninian, everything's gonna be fine. As long as you're with us, you'll be safe. But you witnessed our victory, right? With Syndra's planning and my sword, you've no worries. If we all work together, there's nothing we can't overcome. I don't care who comes after you. I'll not let you be taken. Really? Yes. On my honor. Right, Syndra?
Right.
M'lady? Ah, yes. This is yours. Ah, it's... You called it Ninus's Grace, did you not? That lout had it. M'lady Lindis, thank you so much. I have no other words save thank you.
And with that, Chapter 7X, The Black Shadow, comes to an end. Now, let me tell you about this little thing of Fire Emblem before I end the episode. If you did not like how the map went, or you didn't like how the level ups were, and you feel confident about going through the map again, you can do that. Just don't save over that save file, of course. Put in a new save file. And then just replay the stage. Go through it again. Give it another try. I say this because I really need Lynn to do better. And I'm really tempted to replay the stage and ever kill the boss again. Just because Lynn's my favorite and it's my LP. So those are the only good reasons I have. Oh, that doesn't make it a true Fire Emblem run. Hey, I've seen lots of people do it. You know, the elitist or Fire Emblem people. No, you just gotta stick with those stats and keep going. It's a game. Have fun with it. That's what I would say. If you're doing some super special run, go for it. I already have my own stipulation, which is kind of a stipulation in that a lot of people use anyway, is that if a character dies, I'm restarting the stage. I'm counting that as a game over when that happens. So there's that. If I do end up replaying the Black Shadow, I'll of course tell you about it. I always do that. Anything I do off screen, I give you a full recap. I let you know. And maybe Lynn will get better stats. That'd be great. In other Fire Emblem games, there's even more tricks you can use to get level ups even easier, to redo the stats. You can save right before, let's say, Lynn kills the boss. If you have map saves, you can save. That way, you can't do that in Fire Emblem 7 because of suspend. The way suspend works is you suspend the data and then you reload it, and it erases the suspend data. Also, RNG is set before you do that, so you can't like reset your game hoping that the hit will change. The unit will still get hit because it saves the roll, basically. If that doesn't make a lot of sense, I apologize. I'm just kind of rambling here at the end of the episode, going through things and not doing my typical explanation like I've been doing for this. If that didn't make sense, let me know in the comments and I'll explain it. I'll explain it further. Like I said, if I do end up trying to get Lynn better stats, of course I'll let you know. Regardless, that ends Chapter 7X. Next time, we move on to Chapter 8. Thank you very much for watching. I hope you enjoyed and had a lot of fun. I'm Syndra9. Remember to shoot for the stars, and take care, everyone.